Donald Trump's aardvark anteater bill dad said that you dumb bitches need to see him in court.
I'm the librarian.
And I came to read.
Bitch, they're just walking around here giving any and everybody estates. Bitch, I guess I need to. Bitch, is there an Adrian Expression estate? Bitch, Messy Maya's estate is out here saying,
but girl, Beyonce stole Messy's vocals, girl, and we're gonna need our fucking $20 million check.
Bitch, you hoes are asking for whole net worths, bitch. Your ass, bitch, is Ariana Grande worth that much, bitch? I need for you hoes to back the fuck up like a U-Haul truck because you fucking tried it, bitch. Put the fucking blinkers on, bitch. Somebody needs to see that you're fucking making a maneuver, bitch. Back the fuck up. It's kind It's really messy, and I really don't know how all that YouTube stuff works and what you can use and what you can't use, but for somebody as big as Beyonce, you best to believe that she had her legal team go into that shit and check that shit out. And second of all, bitch, y'all hoes are just looking for a check. Maybe y'all didn't expect Formation to be as big as it was, but when it was released, y'all hoes were on Facebook saying this. Y'all were just so happy. I'm gonna show the pictures. Y'all were just so happy and elated that Beyonce was using his voice, blase, blase, blah. But now that you hoes probably, I don't know, maybe a light bill is due, bitch, or cable, bitch, because I checked my account earlier today and Comcast had came in so quick and snatched that shit out, right out of my goddamn SunTrust. I said, bitch, not goddamn. Maybe y'all hoes saw that, you know, the water bill was too high and you see Formation out here. What happened at the New Orleans type of tease, bitch? You know, maybe you had a roommate move out or some shit and now you have to pay the whole rent. I don't know what the hell is going on, but it really seems inconsistent. Something is definitely insincere here. And for you dumb hoes to not even realize that in the actual song Formation on the actual album, nobody's vocals was on there except Beyonce. So y'all need to do your research before you come out here looking stupid in courts like Donald Trump ass did. I'm gonna talk about his ass later. You need to do your research before you step out here looking like a dumb deer in the middle of the road, bitch, built like Bambi, ho. Just don't know what the fuck your ass doing, bitch. Messy Maya got him goddamn estate, bitch. Bitch, his estate probably his cousin that he don't even fucking remember, bitch, who decided that, bitch, these hoes ain't finna repo my shit.
I just got my car this week, bitch, and I can't pay the goddamn note. I knew Messy Maya, I'ma turn into his estate girl, and we're just gonna make some shit happen, we're gonna make some shit work. I'm going to be able to keep my Impala.
Girl, you hoes aren't fooling me. If you bitches don't run your facts back, check your facts, start paying your credit card bills on time so you won't have to leech off of Beyonce. And what makes it even more disrespectful is that I feel like if he was alive, she would do him just like how she did Big Frida. She was endorsing her, had her all on stage and shit, even though she wasn't paying her taxes. She was very supportive. Like, girl, stop trying to act brand new, bitch. Beyonce finds a way to pay her rent, and I think you need to as well. Migos is out here, I mean, aside from all the other ignorant shit that they are, Migos was out here being homophobic. While you hoes are talking about killing people, shooting people, you got hitters and shit, you fucking all types of bitches, the real sinful shit is the homosexuals. All right, sis. I think I Love McConaughey came out and Migos was asked what's their response to him getting so much support from, you know, the community. And they were just like, you know, the world's fucked up. He was talking about trapping and all this shit. Basically, the fact that he was trapping and moving weight and shit like that, it doesn't match up with him being gay. Let me tell you something. I said this on Twitter, but when I was younger, it's so many dudes I fucked, I know the only thing they was doing was moving weight and they was calling me little mama and shit like that. Like, girl, I don't know where y'all get this idea from. And y'all hoes were in Atlanta. Act like you know, act like you've been there, bitch. I don't know where you get this idea that all gays dress like me, all gays look like me, bitch. I'm sure I done fucked a couple hood ass niggas with a bando or some shit. Like, bitch, it's really not that complicated. Y'all see some fairies like me on mainstream media. Every gay is wearing sheer and crop tops and shit. Every gay got a high pitched ass voice, right? That's what you hoes think? Okay, you are sadly mistaken. Cause I remember I used to be a high school bitch. I used to call trade up so quick. I said, come pick me up. Trade pull up, hood as fuck. Be like,
what's up, Sean? What's up, Lamont?
These hoes are out here. I'm trying to tell you. I just tell him to come pick me up. We go to his house, girl. I would lie to my mama, say I got extra tutoring or some shit, bitch. You take me to his house, girl. The gays are out here doing shit, bitch. And while you hoes are talking about Versace, 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 bitch, you hoes love to drag faggots, but be quick to have gay fashion designers in your fucking music and in your music videos bragging about how you got all these hoes. Girl, like, y'all don't make no sense, bitch. And I guess they realize that, hey, these gays are out here buying our music and shit. And the broke ones like me are at least streaming that shit on Apple Music, so we might as well just gonna clean it up with this trash ass statement from this iPhone Notes ass app. Girl, it was so trash, and they released that shit on Twitter. I say, girl, you could've kept it like the universe kept my testosterone levels. Girl, you could've kept that shit. Oh, we didn't mean to offend anybody. We just meant that the world was fucked up because he was so afraid to come out. Girl, okay, y'all hoes think that you are a wheel of fortune the way that you love to fucking spin some shit around, bitch. I saw how you spun that dumb ass shit, but let me tell you something. You can't buy a vowel, bitch. You you are going to end up on bankrupt. Just hang it up, girl, hang it up. I went on to Twitter and said, bitch, y'all found out that these fags are out here buying your shit, huh? I said, learn from this, like Tyra Banks, bitch. I want you to use this experience. And first of all, don't stereotype all gays. And second of all, we have a lot of other shit to be worried about, especially with this administration. That's what you need to be worried about. Instead of worrying about what I choose to do with a dick and whether it goes in my mouth or my ass. Like, girl, we got bigger fish to fry, bitch. And I'm not even sure if Keisha Cole can help us out with that. Every day that a white person is mad is another day that I get energy. You know when in American Horror Story Coven, when the old Supreme was dying, the new one got fucking power. That's how I get my power, when I make white people angry, bitch. And let me tell you why white people are angry today. Netflix dropped their fucking trailer for Dear White People. They're coming out with a series called Dear White People, you know, associated with the movie. Like, girl, I am shook. These white people are angry as hell. It's, oh my gosh, what if we had a fucking show called Dear Black People? What would you say about that? Girl, Dear Black People is this current administration, girl. We've been experiencing Dear Black People from day one. Like, y'all hoes gonna get this work. Dear White People is just going to be a critique of you. You hoes already hold, I don't understand, you hoes already hold all the money and the power and shit like that. Why are you scared of some goddamn critiques on how we're being treated by the powers that be? That's all it is, we critiquing your ass. Because in the trailer, she was naming, like, okay, here are some cute Halloween costumes, these are acceptable. You know, if you wanna be a pirate or a sailor or something like that. She said, I'm gonna give you a list of the unacceptable Halloween costumes, white people. That's me, bitch. And they showed the black face and shit and they just chopped it, bitch. Yes! Bitch, I cannot wait. I hope that you guys do this properly. I hope that it's well executed. I wish you all of the success and continue to make these cauliflower bill bitches angry. And you can tell the really evil ones, bitch. The white people that are our allies, they look beautiful. They got their skin just all together and shit. The white people that are racist as fuck, like Mr. Bannon over there, bitch, he looked like the surface of the moon, far side of the moon tease, bitch. Girl, craters all in his skin, girl. So let me tell you something. Make these hoes mad, and I'm gonna get my goddamn life. Girl, Donald Trump is out here rolling around like a big ass pork chop in some goddamn mud, bitch. He is constructed like Charlotte's fucking web. What's that pig on Charlotte's web name? Oh, bitch, I think his name is Wilbur. Bitch, Donald Trump is over there rolling around constructed like Wilbur from fucking Charlotte's goddamn web. I am hollering. He is mad as hell. So let me tell you something. Y'all remember when he had that dumbass travel ban, Muslim ban, bitch. A judge stopped that shit from happening because he's being sued. So the case is coming up through the courts. So they're like, in the meantime, while the case is being debated, we're gonna stop this dumbass travel ban. What then the executive branch did, they said, you know what, bitch? We think that while this is being debated, the travel ban should still be happening. And I guess they classified it as an emergencies type of shit. That shit went to the fucking circuit courts. Them hoes reviewed this shit. They said, girl, first of all, we don't even think that the executive order will stand, you know, because they're debating it. We don't think it has a chance of standing. Second of all, this shit is dumb as shit. It don't make no sense. There's no case for emergency, girl. So we're going to revoke your fucking appeal, bitch. And Donald Trump is mad as hell. You know, this is small victories because the case is still in the courts going up. But for now, the cancellation of the ban holds. And that has Donald Trump so angry, bitch. He got his Taylor Swift built ass onto Twitter. Bitch, Taylor Swift's so goddamn fake and trash white feminist that I think her ass was probably playing around on Donald Trump's phone and say, you know what, let me just tweet this shit for you. Donald Trump literally tweeted, see you in court, in all caps. This is in all caps. See you in court. The security of our nation is at stake. That's some dumbass shit to be defeated in court and then try to sound big and bad to say see you in court, bitch. You were just sliced and diced and repriced in goddamn court. What you mean? Are we supposed to be shook that we're gonna see your ass in court again? And the courts that just canceled your shit said that your shit doesn't even look like it has a case? Girl, I'm not shook. Get your dumb see you in court, bitch. I need to see you in somebody's dermatologist's office the way that your skin is set up. Get your life together, you triple chin having ass. So, bitch, you constructed like a whole barrel of beer, bitch. A whole barrel of beer. This is the resistance, ho. I want you hoes to keep the fucking momentum going. Let me tell you something. I think it's November 6, 2018. A lot of these seats that are up because Republicans have control over, I think, all the branches of the fucking government right now. So a lot of these seats, y'all have the power, I think, as I said, on November 6, 2018, to vote these hoes out. Get these hoes out. Get these hoes out of their government seats, bitch. Replace them with hoes that align with their values and that are a part of the resistance so that every time Donald Trump tries to do some dumbass shit, the courts can overturn that shit. Congress can say, fuck that shit. You know, like, we got to keep this momentum going, bitch, right up until 2018 so we can fix this dumb shit that's going on today. Scarlett Johansson, you are the walking image of white feminism when you told us that, essentially, that gender comes before race. For those of you who don't know, Scarlett Johansson is playing a Japanese character in Ghost in the Shell. Like, girl, I don't know how the fuck that fucking happened, but here we are. She's playing a Japanese character, and she just now responded to the controversy saying, you know, I don't want to offend anyone, but, you know, this is a great opportunity for women. Having a franchise with a female protagonist driving it is such a rare opportunity. Some of y'all white people love this feminism thing until it is time to actually adhere to what feminism is supposed to be. How much more feminist would it have been if you let a Japanese woman play the character of a Japanese woman? Girl, give these minorities a chance to have themselves represented in the goddamn media. Because let me tell you something, if y'all continue to whitewash things at this rate, y'all gonna burn a hole in the industry with the bleach that y'all using, bitch. From Egypt to characters that were written in books and now are being adapted for the screen, y'all hoes love to jump in front of fucking minorities trying to get a fucking, like, girl, literally the whole country media society has been around your ass. It's built to help your ass. It's built to make you comfortable. Why the fuck would you want to stand in the way of minorities finally getting a chance to tell their goddamn story? I feel like a lot of people need to go outside their comfort zones of privilege. That even goes for me as a male. Bitch, there are certain things that I don't have to worry about that women do have to worry about. So I think we all need to go outside of our bubbles of privilege, whatever they may be, and truly understand the opportunities that people, some people don't have, and the life chances and glass ceilings that people often experience. Let's work on that, and I would tell Donald Trump to work on his hair loss, but it doesn't really matter because hair is supposed to be protection for your head, a buffer between the environment and your brain so nothing affects it, but you can't really protect what's not there.